We're going to be talking about four issues or conditions of the heart that we have to deal with that can actually damage our relationships with each other, with the people we love, with the people we like, even our work relationships and our friendship relationships. And one of the things that we look at in the four issues that we're dealing with here is all of them in some way create debt in our lives, relational debt. Now, a lot of us are familiar with the concept of financial debt because we live in a society that runs on debt, and a lot of us sometimes feel like we can handle it. But like financial debt, emotional debt can run away with you, right? Mm-hmm. And you can get yourself into a real difficult place because of that.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like when you know that you've wronged a friend, and you're just not quite up to apologizing, or maybe you have apologized and they haven't forgiven you or whatever. Mm-hmm. You want to avoid that person.
Yeah, there's an elephant in the room anytime you see him,
yeah,
right?
Or even there have been times when I've committed to do something and then realized, oh man, that's way too much. And then I kind of avoid that person because I don't want to tell them, well, I really don't want to do it, right? And that is, I owe them a debt. I either owe them the activity I said I was going to do, or I owe them an explanation, but I'm feeling a little bit guilty about it too, so I avoid them.
And it's interesting, even with relationships, we use that kind of debt terminology. Mm-hmm. Like somebody says, you know, well, he at least owes me an apology on that, right? And we don't often think about it that it's in terms of somehow along the way we've created a debt.
Yeah.
And whenever we create a debt, we create an imbalance in that relationship.
Yeah. So either you owe something to someone or they owe it to you, and that causes a dysfunctional relationship.
That's what we want to avoid. So one of the things that we're going to be dealing with is what debts these things create in our lives, mm-hmm. and how we can balance those debts out. Because really, there's only two ways. Well, I was going to say one. There's only two ways that you can actually deal with a debt, mm-hmm. right? It either has to be paid in full, mm-hmm. or it has to be forgiven or canceled,
and
that's the only way that you can get rid of that debt. And you know, consequently, there are a lot of people walking around with big emotional debts, and I find that emotional debt is more insidious than financial debt.
Oh, absolutely, it is.
You tend to get more interest on that quicker, mm-hmm. and it becomes overwhelming at times, and then it spills out into other areas of your life.
Yeah.
So that's one of the reasons why we want to deal with these issues, because we want to balance that debt imbalance out in our hearts and allow God to do some work there so that we can be spiritually debt-free.
And when you're spiritually debt-free, you're in freedom. So, I mean, that's what we want to see people walking in, is freedom. So if you don't owe a debt, or if someone doesn't owe a debt to you, you are walking in freedom.
And we're actually hoping over the next few weeks we're going to have some spiritual mortgage burning parties,
mm-hmm,
for some people, just to see that actually happening.
Yeah.